One of the great traditions at the Haas School is the selection of our commencement speaker. Each year, we call upon an individual of uncommon distinction to address the MBA graduating classes, someone who embodies a commitment to excellence and a distinguished record of achievement, someone who personifies our defining leadership principles. I am honored today to introduce your 2022 commencement speaker, Jagdeep Singh. Jagdeep is a founder, an entrepreneur, and a telecommunications and energy visionary. He's also a graduate of the Evening and Weekend MBA program, class of 1990. In 2010, Jagdeep Singh co-founded QuantumScape, a company on a mission to transform energy storage and support a zero carbon future. Electrical vehicles today account for only about 4% of the world's cars. So how will car manufacturers transition to fully electric fleets? Almost certainly with the help of QuantumScape and the new battery technology it is developing for safer and more economical alternatives to lithium-ion batteries. QuantumScape is just one of Jagdeep's many successes. When data displays on your screen in just fractions of a second, thank Jagdeep and the integrated photon circuitry developed by Infinera Corporation. Jagdeep led Infinera from founding to IPO. Before Infinera, there was Lightera Networks and On Fiber and Airsoft, all hugely successful companies founded by Jagdeep. Jagdeep also leads Deep Valley Labs, the venture laboratory and incubator that he started. It is focused on founding, validating, and spinning out high-impact technology companies. Jagdeep earned his undergraduate degree in computer science from the University of Maryland and his master's in computer science from Stanford and his MBA from Berkeley Haas. Please join me in welcoming Berkeley Haas alum, Jagdeep Singh.
Thank you all. Thank you, Dean Harrison, for that kind introduction. It's great to be back at Haas, great to be back at Berkeley after many years. I have a few prepared remarks, and I'll try to keep things relatively brief. So let me start. So first of all, Dean Harrison, distinguished members of the faculty, staff, family, friends, and most of all, graduating class of 2022. It's an honor to address you today. So you've spent 2 years working late on finance problems, management strategy cases, accounting homework, organizational behavior readings, many other things that you have to do. And you're now, or will soon be, holders of a Haas MBA. You might be asking yourself, what's next? I know I was when I was in your shoes about 30 years ago, graduating with an MBA from Haas, which of course had only just been renamed Haas. At the time, I was a poor graduate student, living on student loans, and to conserve cash and avoid falling deeper into debt, I would often buy a pack of hot dogs and a bag of buns, and to make them last a week, I'd live on one hot dog a day. As I walked from the room I rented in a house on the northeast side of campus to class at Barrows Hall, yep, class was at Barrows Hall back then, I would treat myself on Mondays to a 50-cent hash brown from the McDonald's on University in Shattuck. I remember thinking nothing tasted so good. On the plus side, I did lose a lot of body fat during that time, and I came out leaner, if not meaner. Luckily, we live in a great country, and even someone who starts out as poor as I was can, with some hard work and a bit of luck, achieve their dreams. My dream, since my early days as an undergraduate, was to start a company. I had seen an issue of Time magazine with Steve Jobs on the cover, and that had inspired me to want to be an entrepreneur. After graduating with a degree in computer science, I moved west to work at Hewlett-Packard, considered by many to be the original Silicon Valley startup. I remember coming here, seeing startups like Sun Microsystems and Silicon Graphics go public, and thinking I was too late, that all the startup opportunities had already been taken. Luckily, I was wrong. Kind of like Lord Kelvin, who in 1900 is said to have addressed the British Association for the Advancement of Science by saying, "There's nothing new to be discovered in physics now. All that remains is more and more precise measurement." Of course, that was the same year Max Planck introduced his quantum theory of energy, revolutionizing physics forever. So when it comes to the question of what's next for you, I can't answer that for you. Each of you will forge your own path, your own unique path through the world. What I can do, however, is share a few key thoughts summarizing what I've learned about entrepreneurship in my 30 years of starting companies in Silicon Valley, in hopes that you might find some of these useful as you work to make the biggest impact you're capable of making. While my comments will be framed from the lens of entrepreneurship, luckily, it turns out that, at least I believe, many of these principles turn out to be applicable to almost every walk of life, from working at a big company to even one's personal life. With that as background, here are my five basic thoughts. Number one, pick a big problem. The starting point is the realization that you can't make a big impact if you're playing in a small space. You have to pick big unsolved problems. Picking the right problem, in my view, is the hardest part of making an impact. The problem has to be simultaneously important, i.e., if you solve it, somebody should care, and have an actual chance of being solvable, because if you don't solve it, nobody's going to care. When Einstein chose to work on the theory of relativity, he picked a problem that, if solved, would upend 300 years of Newtonian physics. The fact that he was then actually able to solve it is, of course, what made him immortal in the world of physics. Of course, picking a big problem doesn't automatically mean you will succeed at solving it. But it's far more fun to fail at something big than succeed at something small. The most fulfilling, most memorable projects to me have been the ones that look mind-blowingly disruptive when first proposed, yet paradoxically look inevitable when viewed through the lens of hindsight. Building a startup electric car company in one of the most expensive parts of the country, with a powertrain made of consumer-grade laptop batteries, is an example of something that sounds ridiculous at first glance, but then seems inevitable, now that the electric car revolution is upon us. Here's the good news. The world right now has lots of huge unsolved problems, from political polarization to climate change, from artificial general intelligence to augmented humanity, from disease to inequality. So you have lots of big problems to choose from. Pick one that you have a passion for, that you can't help but want to spend all your time, day and night on, even if others think it's too idealistic, too big, or too unsolvable. Your Berkeley MBA is now. You don't need to settle. Which brings me to my next point. Be contrarian and right. When it comes to picking problems, the best advice I ever got was this: be contrarian and right. Picking problems is a bit like picking a stock. If you pick one that everyone likes, then that belief is already priced in, and even if you're right, there's limited upside. And of course, if you're wrong, then you're wrong, and there's definitely downside. So the trick is to pick something contrarian, something few people think can work, but to be right. Many of the most disruptive contributions made to our society were made by people pursuing ideas that were considered impractical at best, or downright ridiculous by many. The first step is to pick an idea that's contrarian. A contrarian approach can be one that's never been tried, or has been tried, but has failed. If everyone agrees your idea is a great one, it's by definition not contrarian. So ironically, you need some naysayers to validate your idea. The second step, once you pick a contrarian idea, is to maximize the chances of being right and actually being able to pull it off. Doing this requires doing an intense level of homework on the idea. Learn everything there is to know about the idea, why previous approaches failed, who the best people in the space are, and be brutally honest with yourself about the merits of the idea. Don't let anyone else tell you it will never work. But don't convince yourself it will work without having the confidence that comes from truly having done a deep dive and profoundly understanding the problem and your solution. If you can do both these things, you have a good chance of being contrarian and right. I've been lucky to have had a chance to work on more than one such problem. In fact, in many ways, my entrepreneurial career has been a series of contrarian bets. Luckily, they've generally turned out okay. So this approach has worked for me. Number three, build a world-class team. So here's the thing. There aren't a lot of big problems that you can solve on your own, and few storms you can weather alone. You need a team with world-class talent in all the key areas your specific project requires, who bring knowledge and capabilities you don't have, and who can work together with you to help scale the mountain. So what's a world-class team? It's not just people you like hanging out with. They need to have a few key qualities. IQ and deep domain expertise is, of course, table stakes. But what you really need is people who have a deep-rooted commitment to the mission, a commitment which allows them not to be swayed or spooked when the inevitable issues come up. No startup is a straight shot, just like no attempt on a challenging peak will be without setbacks, whether it's weather or avalanches or crevasses. But here's the good news. When you choose a really big, hard problem, it gets easier to attract a world-class team because the best people want to work on the biggest and hardest and most impactful problems. And with a team like this, you just might pull it off. In this sense, it can actually be easier to solve the really big and hard problems. Yet another reason to go big. Number four, take the initiative and just try. Some of you might follow basketball. Actually, any Warriors fans in the house here? All right. I think we can agree that Steph Curry is one of the best shooters in the history of basketball. But even Steph Curry can have bad shooting nights. But what makes someone like him truly great is even when he's not shooting well on a given night, he has the confidence to still be taking shots. More shots on goal, which of course increases the number of shots in goal. As an entrepreneur, you have to do, not just sit on the sidelines. I learned a long time ago with my first startup that our system actually rewards taking the initiative even more than it does being right. When you take the initiative and start making progress towards a vision, you can inspire others, and even if your full vision isn't realized, you can create value in the process. And the more attempts you make, the more right you will ultimately be. Studies on contemporary geniuses have found that one of the defining characteristics of people considered by their peers to be geniuses is that they have a lot more good ideas than the non-geniuses. But it turns out, they also have a lot more bad ideas. They just have more ideas, period. It's not that they're always right. Rather, they take chances and are wrong a lot of the time, but in the process, they may generate a few ideas that are profound or build something mind-blowingly disruptive, yet inevitable. And that brings me to my fifth and final thought. When you take on big problems and big, hairy, audacious goals, when you're being contrarian, when you jump in and try, you will make mistakes. Own those mistakes, learn from them, and try never to make the same mistake twice. If you live your life with this principle, you'll get better and better at what you do, and before you know it, you'll be playing the game at a higher level than you ever thought possible. With these few words, I wish you all the success life has to offer as you pursue your own big, hairy, audacious goals, goals I believe your time at Haas has prepared you well for. Best of luck, class of 2022. I look forward to truly great things, big ideas, and contrarian solutions from you. This is your time and your place. Thank you.